Hi everyone, welcome to TV1 Business Bureau, where we are going to have a quality conversation with an interesting personality and also let's get ourselves updated with the latest trending business news. We all love to listen to stories, and if it's an inspiring story, we would also love to listen to it because it inspires and motivates us. So it's time to listen to inspiring, interesting conversation by two interesting personalities who are once CFOs but now entrepreneurs. So let's now talk to the co-founders of InsureMe.lk, Vipula and Indika.
For me, success comes from attention to details.
For me, action. You have to act fast.
It's time to have a quality conversation with two interesting personalities. If you talk to accountants, their dream is to become a CFO. But the interesting fact is, these two amazing personalities are CFOs. But the problem is that they were satisfied being CFOs, but then later decided to be entrepreneurs. So today we are going to talk to former CFOs of two leading companies and also the co-founders of InsureMe.lk. Vipula and Indika, how are you doing? I'm doing great as well, thank you very much. And I'm sure you're waiting to share some interesting experiences and tips for our viewers and our youth as well. So maybe let's first talk, what made you become entrepreneurs?
For me, it was part of my dream. I wanted to be an accountant anyway, so that was my initial dream. And then to be a CFO of a leading company was an achievement. But then when you do it for some time, you feel, okay, might as well you try something else. So that's the end of the CFO life, starting a different life, not to go to another company, but to start your own, and that's how we are today.
So you achieved your dream.
I'm achieving today. I'm
You're right. Achieving your dream. Interesting. There's a lot more to come, isn't it?
Should be.
Indika, when you started learning accountancy, did you ever imagine that one day you will become a CFO?
Yeah, just like any other accountant, when I was doing my accounting studies, I wanted to be an accountant, and then after I passed out, I had my dreams, like within 5 years I will be a finance manager and maybe within 10 years be a head of finance and a CFO.
So while you were studying, did you have a plan as well?
Not a specific plan. My number one objective was to be an accountant and after that to find a good job. And once I found my job, then I had my plans. Within 5 years I want to be this and within 10 years I want to be that. That's how I planned.
That's fantastic. And Vipula, you too was a CFO of a leading company. Did you also have a dream, or you automatically kept on promoting, getting promoted continuously?
For me, CFO wasn't the dream initially, but then when you started learning, you start loving something. So I started loving what I was used to do. And that brought me to become the CFO. So, idea is whatever you do, if you do it with your passion, you start loving it. So that love brought me to become the CFO, right? So I don't think I dreamed to be a CFO when I was schooling or when I was in the uni. So you run it, so you have fun and you own that life, right? But then when you find something what you love, you can become the top of it. So that is what brought me to become the CFO. And I was the CFO for some time and then thought of, okay, enough to be a CFO one day. That's how the next journey starts.
I think just to add, maybe it's hard work plus you need a bit of luck as well.
Yeah. As Vipula and Indika said, what I understood is, do what you love and love what you do. Vipula, I would like to ask you, when did you come up with this idea? When did you want to start becoming an entrepreneur?
So that was in my dream anyway. It is not something came out on just one day thought. But then before starting anything, I want to ensure that I have a base to work on. That is why I became an employee and then became a corporate executive. And then through your job, you learn a lot of things, right? When you become a CFO of organization, you know, get to know everything of that company, each and everything, from bottom to the top. Because you are dealing with each and everybody. And you see the seats with the organization, because you see the numbers of organizations and how does that number come from. And I was thinking, okay, if you know everything and if you could help yourself now, go and set up your own thing because you know the basics. Right? It was easy. And then Indika and I used to be very good friends, even though we were in the same industry rival companies. We became very close buddies, even our families are the same. And then we used to travel a lot for our jobs and all, and then probably have drinks in the evening as friends. And then this thought came up, we should start something, madam. So that's how really this idea came up, and then gradually we settled down in our jobs. And then one day we decided, now it is enough, let's go out.
I think as people said, when we traveled together to Hong Kong, Singapore, we saw the world a little differently. What was there and what is not here. So we saw a huge gap and we thought one fine day we should start. So that's how it has started.
So why don't you have a coffee and come to the discussion? I think it's interesting.
That would be great, because after drink you all became buddies. Maybe we can have a quality conversation while having coffee as well.
Okay. Let's have coffee now then.
Yes, time for coffee. So while we enjoy the coffee, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after this short break. Becoming an entrepreneur itself is a tough task, and also starting a new company, Inshomi.lk, is an interesting one, and it's new to the country. It's a new concept. I know that it's not easy to start a new company, and especially something new to the market, because you need to build the trust. So what are the challenges you faced while starting Inshomi.lk and also after initiating this amazing company?
There were a few challenges, because as you said, it's a new concept to the market. It's a new thing to Sri Lanka, and insurance is a regulated industry. So we had to join hands with the regulators and then get all the insurance companies into one single platform, so that technology should talk to all the companies, which was not an easy task. We had an excellent IT team. I think they delivered that. The main challenge was that. And then in consumers' mind, it's an online thing, it's a digital thing. They were used to buy insurance through other channels. So getting them into that was the second challenge. Well, I think
changing the people mind is the worst challenge and is the challenge. Because initially we had to convince the insurance regulators that Sri Lanka should have an aggregate. Because there was no law for that. And then when it comes to insurance company management, it is a secret formula, insurance pricing, right? You don't want to show you how do you price to others.
Magic
but now
box.
You can see online. So that was a change, a significant change in their mindset. As probably I think we had been in the industry and we were trustworthy to them. And we could, I think, convince them, okay, guys, this is something interesting. And it's happening in other parts of the world. Why not in Sri Lanka? So that is how we break the challenge. After convincing the insurance company's management, the next challenge was how best we can use the technology to integrate the services and give the customer a better experience. And it also took some time, because the technology that we wanted to build wasn't there off the shelf. It had to be built from the inception. We had a good, great team. We have the great team, I think, entirely done by intern of our team. And we launched it in, we started this journey. I resigned from the company on 1st April, good nice day. Because I started my working life on the first April. And I resigned from that job also on the 1st April.
Insurance is all about relationships. When it comes to Inshomi.lk, what kind of relationship are you building with your customer?
Yeah, it's about relationships, and we start the relationship digitally, and always the customer has the option either to be digitally full or to develop a relationship. So we have the option, or the team, expert team. We'll talk about that in a bit more detail. Because as you very correctly say, insurance is about relationship and trust. Right? And for you to build the trust, you need to have trustworthy people. And but in Insureme.lk, what we want to do is, we are not trying to tell you buy only this. We are saying there are choices for you. Right? A, B, C. Right? Depending on your need, we can customize the product for yourself. So for that you need an expert team. You know the product A to Z. Right? So what we want to say is, okay, digitally you can start your journey, but always you have the advice of a professional expert team with Insureme. Right? Either you can meet them, or even call them, or even chat with them. Right? So through all these mechanisms, you can develop the trust with them, relationship with Insureme.lk. And finally, insurance is bought to meet a claim, right? So when you have a claim, you need to get that. Right? That's the whole objective, right? Insurance is not to just to pay money to somebody else.
I think the other thing is relationship building, it's a journey. Like a test match ekak gahanna wage wadak. It won't happen in a day or two. It's a journey, you have to be very patient. And we have to take them through that journey, especially since we're a digital company, you know, we have to take them through that journey, and it might take a while.
When it comes to insurance, most of the people go to the insurance company and buy insurance, or they will get the insurance through an agent. So why should a person buy or get the insurance through Insureme.lk?
I think the core reason is the options that are available. It's always better to compare before you buy. Say for example, motor insurance, there are 7-8 companies who provide the solutions. So then you compare the prices, you compare the options, and then buy the best option. And when it comes to life insurance, those are long-term products. So rather than buying a product that going to 15-20 years buying through an agent, might as well you come and compare what are the options that are available so that you go ahead to the best option. So that's the main reason why they should come to insure.
So what we want to do is, even in other markets, I think initially this is how insurance started, but gradually people now move into comparing the best choice and maybe combine different products from different companies for your portfolio, right? And then you know that, okay, for my health insurance, I have a best product of this market. My investment, I have another best product of the market. And for my other need, I have a next best product. So like that, I have combined a pool of products. Whereas if you buy today's model, you will only get to know about one. Okay, this is the best product. So that's others, you're basically focusing only one area. So in some of the other markets, now even people use a lot of technology, even robots in this process, like give the details of different products, compare benefits, right? And even project the returns for future, right? So that is why the importance of using technology for insurance and compare the options with the technology.
We all love to talk about our childhood because we have lovely memories about our childhood. Vipula, let's talk about your childhood.
Yeah, I'm from Kegor, and I went to Pinnala Central College. And in the school, I wasn't a very good student, honestly, because I was not that best set of students in the teacher's book. But I enjoyed doing that because I was more towards, I think, being out of the class than within the class. But I think, and it was a good time for us to, I think all of us, to develop friends, relationships, genuine relationship which last forever. And then out of the school I went to, when I was uni, I really understood, okay, now it's time for me to think about my future. Because what I saw in the university life was like most people just come to uni and then think about maybe finding somewhere a job and then get back to that like average day-to-day life. But I didn't want to be part of that life. Because when I look at my history, one of the weakness I saw in myself was communication, especially English. But when I started university life, I realized, okay, now it's my time. Well, either I should select to be good in communication or I should forget about it. So then my choice was to be, okay, now I should face a challenge, right? And then started. A lot of commitment was given to how best I can Because if you're in the corporate world, you need English. That was the biggest challenge at that time in my life. Mostly what I used to do was like reading, watching films was like, I love it. And like I can read, I can watch films, so read books till overnight without sleeping. Just my, even today, sometimes when I go home after maybe very hard work day, sometimes I don't sleep for next 4 hours. I just read books. I love it. Or maybe watch a film. That taught me a lot. And most of my learning in my life, I think, is coming out of these things. And I wasn't a sports star anyway, so not that, I wasn't good at that. But I think Indiga, anything?
For me, in my case, a little bit different. I'm from Matra, studied in Matra Rahul. I was involved in sports as well. I played football for my school, and I was a swimmer. I was in swimming squad as well. Up to O levels, I was an ordinary student, but I did really well in my A levels. I became fourth in the island. And after that, even at the university, again, played football for university, and then was a swimmer as well there. And yeah, I mean, as you could have said, there were challenges in life when you, I mean, from you come from Matra to Colombo, and you know, the corporate world, the communications, and where to study, the way the things are happening around you, where to get used to it. I think we successfully overcome. When I have a leisure time, my hobbies are like photography. I love photography. I don't have time for that though. And swimming. I love to swim, and continue with that.
So we got to know that you have won many awards in financial reporting. So let's talk about it.
Those are the annual report awards, that is for financial reporting. We have in Sri Lanka and in the South Asia region as well. In South Asia, it's called SAFA, South Asia Federation of Accountants. And we two were competing each other in that. But we managed to do it for 8 years, people. And his company and the companies that I represented, we were within top three in the region for about 8 consecutive years. Like, we won not only in the insurance sector, we have won awards for across all the sectors. We won gold, silver, bronze for about, in that 8 years, we were within top three consecutively, isn't it?
Congratulations on that. Finally, Indika and Vipula, what is the message you would like to share with our upcoming entrepreneurs and also the professionals who are watching today?
I think I start with the professional, because if you want to be either engineer or accountant or doctor, there is a process to be followed. It has to be, you need to follow the education and experience parallelly. Most of the people I have seen today is sometimes you have at least all the qualification you want, but you don't know how to work. Or sometimes you know you are best workers, but you don't have the qualification to back you up. So when you are in a corporate ladder, you need the both, right? And most of the, especially my profession is in accounting. So most of the young accountants or students, what I can tell is, don't try to mix up with all these courses what is in the world, right? So accounting is accounting. So which course, select the best course you can follow, maybe depending on your interest as well as the ability to finance, and then ensure that you complete it nicely. Don't try to start one or two together. It doesn't give you a value. And then be good at it, and then while you are doing the education, ensure that you work for somebody, especially a quality boss. Right? More than anything, if you are with a good boss, you can learn a lot. That boss can change your life. I think while you are doing your exams, halfway through, ensure that you work for a good place, and more importantly, to a good boss. A good boss can change your life. Sindhika?
I think, apart from that, essentially you are working in a team. In a corporate, you won't work in isolation. So, different players will have different attitudes, their own viewpoints. So, I think working in a team is also very important. And commitment and focus, it's also very important, because things won't happen the way you want, and it takes time. So, you have to be very patient and continuously deliver. That is what is important.
It was interesting conversation that we had, and also a quality conversation, and we learned a lot of things, and I'm sure you learned a lot of things as well, because talking about the journey of CFOs and also how an accountant, a CFO, became an entrepreneur. This is the beginning of a massive success story, and we are waiting to hear about that success story as well. So thank you very much, the co-founders of InsureMe.lk, Vipula and Indika. It was nice meeting you and also to get to know about your journey. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
It was nice to have you on TV One Business Bureau program, and see you soon. Wish you all the best. Thank you very much. And thank you very much for joining with TV One Business Bureau Talk with the Boss segment. So see you next week, same time on TV One Business Bureau with me, Bernadine Jansinger.